In the beginning, Walt used to go to Griffith Park with his two daughters and take them on the carousel ride that was there and let them go on the swings and everything. And he'd sit there and watch them have a good time. And that's kind of when it all started to click in his head about maybe there should be something for the families to go to. So it was the mother, father, the children, whatever. It wasn't just the kids. So that was the idea that kind of kicked him off and got him started. And then from there, he went to Knott's Berry Farm. And they'd started sort of a, not a theme park, but they had bought and built a ghost town. And Walt just loved the ghost town that they had down there. And he watched the people and their families and everything. And that kind of helped spur the idea even stronger that he should do something for family entertainment, outdoor entertainment. So that's basically the beginning in his head. He actually then had 10 acres across the street from Disney Studio, and he actually had some of his designers draw up a little theme park idea to go onto the 10 acres. And I think once that was completed, he realized that it was too small for the ideas that he wanted to put in there. So he started to give it some thought about what the size should be. And somewhere along the line, he'd heard about that Stanford University had a division that could kind of help him with the growth of Southern California. So Walt contacted Stanford University and told him kind of what he wanted and what he was interested in. And they, in turn, introduced him to a gentleman by the name of Buzz Price. So Buzz Price was brought onto the kind of the ideas of where should we build this. And there was a rumor at one time that Walt might build the theme park in the San Fernando Valley. Well, Buzz says, no, no. He says the growth of Southern California is going to be going south. So he suggested the best thing to do would be to do it in Anaheim, in that area. So by this time, Walt has pretty much started visualizing what the park should be. But he needed financing. And so he got a hold of Herb Ryman, who was one of the his illustrators there at the studio, and sat down with Herb for a solid weekend at Herb's house and said, let's do a master plan. So the interesting thing about it is Herb and Walt did this master plan in one weekend, which basically was the real plan. So he did that and he took it to New York to get financing. So what happened was, obviously, things started to fall into place because of that. And that's when they acquired the property in Anaheim. And at that time, this was around 1953. I had started working in animation in 1952. And I was there at the beginning of all this, but none of us in animation knew what the hell was going on. And then around 1953, we used to see things at the on the lot that was really quite different, because pretty soon you saw Walt riding around in a carriage, or sometimes you'd see him in a stagecoach drawn by horses, and he was always wearing cowboy hats and boots and stuff, and we thought, what the hell's going on? So the rumor did get out that Walt was planning on doing some sort of an entertainment area. And so we kind of really enjoyed it. In fact, there were times when the helicopter would land right in the field out front there, and we never knew what the hell was going on, because it was kept pretty secret. Okay, when Walt decided to build Disneyland, he wanted to create a company that was in charge of the design of it. So he called this company WED, which was his father's initials, Walter Elias Disney. And that's where the name, in fact, Walt loved to play with names. He had another company that was called Retlaw, which was Walter spelled backwards. And that was a company that was set up to some of the parts of the park that Walt continued to own. And so the money that was made off of that went to his family. So he loved playing with little names like that. But anyway, that's what WED was. And so WED was on the third floor at the Disney Animation Building when they designed Disneyland. And a lot of the fellows that worked up there, in fact, I had an office up there when I was first asked to come to work for WED. So it was within the studio property, but then there was a concern, a legal issue, that they weren't allowed to have two companies on the same piece of property. So we had to move Wed out of Disney studio, and we went over to Sonora. They leased a little building on Sonora, and Wed was moved over there, and that's where we all went over and became employees at the Wed. And that was the beginning, which was kind of interesting because at that point in time, I think there was only 60 people that worked at Wed, and that included the janitors, the secretaries, the designers, and everything. So 60 of us were in charge, and that group of 60 are the ones that started doing everything up to the World's Fair, and which is absolutely amazing. I mean, we did the Tiki Room with that, and it was a great time frame. It was really fun.